Module 5, the topic K-means. K-means clustering. First, what is K-means? K-means clustering intends to partition n objects into K cluster, in which each object belongs to the cluster with the nearest means. So this method produces exactly K different cluster of greatest possible distinction. So this is of K-means. And moreover, it has some prototype. So it is a prototype based clustering technique, create a one level partitioning of data objects. There are a number of such techniques, but two of most prominent are K-means. The objective of K-means cluster is to minimize total intra-cluster variance or squared error function. So based on this prototype only, the particular technique of K-means is going to play a role. Okay, these are the technique. Okay, this is of one technique, and the main objective of K-means clustering is to minimize total intra-cluster variance, or we can call it as squared error function. Right. So moving on to the next slide, K-means clustering. Generally here each point is then assigned to cloud centroid, okay, centroid, or each collection of a provide assigned to be centroid in a cluster. So this centroid, this centroid of each cluster is then updated based on points assigned to the cluster. Right, as like early we discussed in the previous slide, when we are going to perform the cluster, if you want one cluster, two cluster, etc., up to n number of cluster, within the specified distance, within the specified location we are going to consider, based on that only, based on the particular updated point only, we are going to perform this cluster operation. The centroid of each cluster is then updated based on the points assigned to the cluster. And like what we'll do, this procedure we will be repeating, the assignment and update of the steps until the changes of cluster are equivalently, until the centroids remains the same. So this particular task we will be repeating unless and until we achieve the final task. Right. Now this K-means cluster, the K-means algorithm is an algorithm to cluster and objects based on attributes into K partition. So number of K partitions where K is less than n. And next step, it is similar to the expectation and maximization algorithm for mixtures of Gaussians, in that they both attempt to find the centers of natural clusters in the data, and it assumes that the object attributes form a vector space. So this is all about K means clustering. So how the K-means clustering algorithm works over here? The data in Euclidean space means the Euclidean distance is 1, which measures the quality of the clustering. Using the technique of first one, the sum of squared errors. So we can, abbreviation we can say it as SSE, sum of squared errors, which is also known as scatter. In other words, we calculate error of each data point in its Euclidean distance. So for that, like this particular computation, the sum of squared errors computation, that we are going to perform the task. Okay, this is all about the Euclidean. And here like K-means clustering algorithm, how it will work. First we have to begin with the decision on the value of K is equal to number of clusters. And next step, put any initial partition that classifies the data into K cluster. You may assign the training samples randomly or systematically as the following. So in that, the first one, again the first category is take the first K training sample as single element clusters. And second one, next step is assign each of the remaining n minus K training sample to the cluster with the nearest centroid. So after each assignment, recompute the centroid of the gaining cluster. So another two steps, like unless and until, as we discussed, to achieve the clustering we have to repeat the previous steps. Take each sample in sequence and compute its distance from the centroid of each of the cluster. If a sample is not currently in the cluster with the closest centroid, switch the sample to the cluster and update the centroid of the cluster, gaining the new sample and the cluster losing the sample. And the last step, repeat step 3 until convergence is achieved, then until a pass through the training sample cause no new assignments. And now this k-mean clustering algorithm, how it works, we discussed. Now how we are going to document the data. So document data over objective and k-means into the maximize similarity of the documents in a cluster to cluster centroid. So the class the quality of the cluster is known as cohesion of cluster. So here the total cohesion of a cluster based on that going to solve it. And k means additional issues. So additional issues, and whenever issues comes, like we will be talking about the problems, weakness. So there are two strategies that decreases the total SSC by increasing the number of cluster. And split a cluster with the largest SSC, usually it chosen, but we could split the cluster with large data set. And we will introduce a new cluster centroid. Often the point that is fastest from any cluster will be chosen. Another approach is to choose randomly from all points or from the point with highest SSC. So the strategies, the various other strategies, let us discuss the weakness of k-means clustering. When the number of data are not so many, initial grouping will be determined the cluster significantly. The number of cluster k must be determined beforehand. So its a disadvantage is that it does not yield the same result with each run, since the resulting cluster depend on the initial random assignments. So we never know the real cluster using the same data because of it is inputted in the different order. It may produce different cluster if the number of data is few. And next one, it is sensitive to initial condition. Different initial condition may produce different result of cluster. The algorithm may be trapped in local optimum. And conclusion. So before move on to the conclusion, the k-means we will be performing by bisecting k-mean. What is bisecting k-mean? So the algorithm is a straightforward extension of basic k-mean algorithm that is based on simple idea to obtain k cluster. Split the set of all points into two cluster and select one of the cluster to split, and so on until the k cluster have been produced. Okay, so as like we know, the strength and weakness we discussed. Even more efficient and respective initialization problem will be there, and it is not suitable for any all type of data. So in detail, like we discussed, now we overview we go through, and also trouble in clustering the data that contain outliers. And these k-means is restricted to data for which there is a centroid, where there is a centroid. So that issue will be facing. And final conclusion, the k-means algorithm is useful for undirected knowledge discovery and is relatively simple. So k-means has found widespread usage in lots of field, ranging from unsupervised learning of neural network, pattern recognitions, classification analysis, artificial intelligence, image processing, machine vision, and many others. So next topic we'll discuss in module 5, agglomerative hierarchical clustering. Agglomerative, what is agglomerative, and with respect to the hierarchical structure, agglomerative hierarchical structure, how it is, and what are the uses. So we'll discuss in the next slide.